So students, we can do at our home. Everybody can do this because this whatever thing required here for experiment, it's present with us. There's one table required, cup is there. Okay, one glass also you can take, thread and nut is there. So thread, everything is available at our home, so we can use it. So what we have to do, we have to take one plastic cup which we are using for drinking tea. Yeah, that also we can use here. And make a hole. Take a long thread, double it and pass it through the hole and tie a thick enough knot. Is the knot you know now very well? You have to tie a thick knot. Knot means there in Marathi we can say the gat marni. Correct, no? We have to tie it, make it here like this knot. You will see here, this is here knot one. Okay? Like this knot you have to make, means that thread will not come out. What is the purpose behind it? That thread will not come out. So, taking care that two loose ends are below the bottom of the cup, tie a knot each to the two ends as shown in the figure. So, we have to do like this our arrangement here. And then, this figure A as an arrangement. Knot means any circular thing there, object you can take. Okay, if it's possible, you will get knot which you are using for fitting the screws. Okay. And then put on the table. Keep one of the nuts in the cup and another is there downside. Here you can see one nut is there inside and one nut is outside. And then as shown in the figure, when the cup is sliding along the table, stop it by putting a ruler in its path. What we have to do? We have to keep here. If you keep this cup here, this nut is downside. Due to it, what happened? Automatically, this cup will be coming down like this. Yes or no? Because already this is tied, this nut is tied with this thread here. We have packed here. And due to reason, when this is downside, this will be come down. Yes? Why this happened? Can you tell me? What's the reason behind it? Anybody can tell? If you do like this arrangement, one nut is inside, one nut is outside, and we have kept one nut downside, we little kept it lower, then it will be come down.
Because of the gravity.
Because of the gravity. And another thing, what is happening here, it's not a stable here.
Mass is increased.
Yeah, this mass is here, correct, that point is here. What's here? Mass. Due to the mass, what happened? It will be comes down. Okay, because here is no support. If there is no support, then it will be not stable there. Here we are going to keep this support like as a scale or ruler. Due to that reason, it will be stopped. Okay, getting it? Then we have to do another one experiment. Same. What we have to do here? We have to take same plastic cup, three nuts, and we have to tie like as a first one same, but this time we have to leave these two nuts downside, not only one single. Okay. And we have to take this thread same. Eh? If thread is there unequal, then it's not possible. When you take there unequal, that time what will happen here? Automatically, where is there bigger thread, it will be come down. It will be pulling here, this side. Okay. Here what happened? It was pulling this side before keeping the ruler. But where if their unequal thread is there, then it will be pulled that side only. Okay, so due to that reason, we have to take their equal threads, equal length of it. And from this, we are getting it. If there are equal forces applied on it, equal forces, what is there? Equal forces on it, then it will be stable. And if their equal forces will be not there, then it will be there unstable, or we can say balance and unbalance. Okay, then another thing, this is coming towards the ground, there is another one very important reason that is behind it, the gravitational force. If there is no force acting on that body, then gravitational force acts on that body and it will be always attract towards the center of Earth. If you throw the ball, what we are playing there, rubber ball or any one ball is there, upside. After some time, it will be come down. Have you observed this? Have you played cricket or either any other games with balls? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. So So here, with the help of this, we can understand positive, negative, and zero work. So when gravitational force is there acting on that object, it will be displaced toward the earth. That time it is the positive work will be there. And when any object leaving the earth's orbit, means like this, suppose from our surface we are throwing it up, that time is here negative work, because it's opposite to the gravitational force. And there is a balance, there is a no change in its objects, their moment, that is called their zero work, it's stable. Okay, understood everyone? Yes or no?
Yes.
Now Institute of Math. Now see their National Physical Laboratory in 1943, it established its function of the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research. So in this research, this our laboratory is there. There is so many experiments about the physics going on and about the development of work, how to work is used. Nowadays we are using there so many machineries. So these machines, how we developed after the experiment, not directly. Okay, so in our India also one very nice institute there, name is there, National Physical Laboratory. It's there 1943, and it's work like at the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research. Okay. So now some examples here given for you. It was just you can take more information about this institute. Can you do it? Yes or no? It's very easy work for you.
Yes, sir.
Now we'll see the next. There's some examples are there. Now students, pay attention toward the example. Don't look here and there. Some students are looking here and there while I'm explaining, and then afterwards they might be, they face the problem solving the examples. In this our part one, science one, there's some examples, equations are there. So pay attention towards it. Mathematics included in it. Okay. And one more thing, one instruction is there. I'm going to tell you that you have to complete your homework in right time. Okay. Because now we'll call you for checking your homework. You'll get that your numbers, and that day you have to come and you have to check your concern, subject teachers concern notebooks. Okay. So calculate the work done to take an object of mass 20 kg to a height of 10 meter. What is there? We have to find the calculate work. What is the work formula? Will tell me. What is the work formula?
Force into displacement.
But here, if you see there, calculate the work done to take an object of mass 20 kg to a height of 10 meter. Here height is given. Okay. So height is there 10 meter. Then what is given there? Mass m. M is equal to 20 kg. So here this is your height, means here your displacement. But it above from the earth surface, so it will be there. We have to take, it will be there negative or positive, will tell me.
Negative.
Okay. So before that, we'll see first force we'll find by our regular formula, that is when gravitational force is applied on that object, that is F is equal to M into G, means mass into gravitation. So what is the mass? Mass is a 20 kg. Height is a 10, we'll think about it afterwards. Then G, 9.8 meter per second square, this value you have to keep in mind, G is equal to 9.8 meter per second square. So F is equal to M into G. Why? Because it's a gravitational force here, and it's opposite to, means it's not attracting, it's going upwards from the earth surface. Due to that reason, we have taken this minus 9.8. So 20 into minus 9.8, then we will get the multiplication. F is equal to minus 196 newton. Understood all of you? Yes or no? Why that negative
sign? Yes, sir.
Because displacement is opposite to the direction of the force, that is the against the gravitational force. So then we'll get here F is equal to minus 196 newton. Then W is equal to F into S, work done. This was the only force. We have to find the work done. So here minus 196 into 10. What will you get? Minus 196 multiplied by 10, you'll get there 1960. But sign is there minus. Their reason is also given behind it. The negative sign appears because the direction of force is opposite to the displacement. So due to that reason, this work is positive or negative, students?
Negative.
Why it's negative? What's the reason behind it?
Because it is against the gravity.
Yeah, because it's against the direction, we can say against the gravity. Now, second problem. Praveen has applied a force of 100 Newton on an object. 100 Newton. Force is given directly in the form of Newton at an angle of 60 degrees to the horizontal. So, there 60 degrees there. The object gets displaced in the horizontal direction. So, you will take like this one triangle here now. Okay. Force here, F is given. Suppose like it's here, 100 Newton. Then, the object get displaced. 60 degree angle, suppose here. This is your 60 degree angle. Means here, cos theta is there, cos 60. Understood? Then, object get displaced the horizontal direction and 400 joule work it done. Work, how much done here? 400 joule. Whatever given things, understand and write as it is. If you are not getting anything, then also first write these given things. You will get some idea from it. Then what is the displacement of the object? What we have to find their displacement means, yes. We know the formula. Work done is equal to F into S. So now see, you have got their formula also. You got some information also. First, we have to find the work done in the form of theta. Cos theta. So cos theta we have to there W is equal to Fs cos theta. So W already 400. Don't think about this because cos 60 value already given here 1 upon 2. Cos 60 value is given 1 upon 2. So 400 is equal to 100 into S into 1 half. Then this 2 is here for division. It will become here for multiplication. Getting it? So it will be here for multiplication. These 2, their 100 is in here for multiplication, it will become here for division. 100 on the 100, 100 for the 400 into 2. What will you get? 4 to the 8. So displacement will be there 8 meter. Understood, everyone?
Yes.
Any doubt? If any queries, you can ask any questions related to this problem, you can ask immediately. Nobody's hanged out? Okay, so we'll see the why does it happen. There is a question. If a pot having a plant is kept in the dark, the plant languishes. Why this happen? Can you tell me?
Because it is not getting sunlight.
Yeah, it's not getting sunlight. Another? Anyone want to tell? Shreya Kale, what's the reason behind it? If you keep any plant which is in pot, you are kept in the dark. It will be languishes means sky with the comezunzain. Yes, Chaitali?
As sunlight is the energy, so there is no energy to the plant. That's why it will languish.
Yeah. Another, is there somebody, Katha, do you want to tell anything?
For the photosynthesis, sunlight is essential that it will not be dark.
Yeah, correct. Due to the energy means for plants, they are absorbing their energy from the sunlight. Okay, if you provide water and all things, but sunlight is not there, then it will be languishes. Means without the sunlight, it can't produce their own food. With the help of by process that photosynthesis process. On increasing the volume of music system or TV beyond a limit, the vessels in the house start vibrating. Why this happen? टीव्हीचा आवाज त्याच्या नेहमीच्या आवाजापेक्षा भरपूर मोठा केला किंवा म्युझिक सिस्टीमचा तर ते व्हायब्रेट व्हायला लागेल घर तर कशामुळे डू यू नो व्हॉट्स द रिझन बिहाइंड देर इज अ रिझन बिहाइंड इट दिस साऊंड एनर्जी लाईट एनर्जी इज कनेक्टिंग टू द साऊंड एनर्जी रिमेंबर दिस लाईट एनर्जी इज कनेक्टिंग टू द साऊंड एनर्जी अँड दॅट इट्स बियॉन्ड द लिमिट Then automatically it will be vibrate. Music system will be not there stable due to the sound is beyond the limit there. Now, if at our home there is a small speaker, then it will not vibrate that much. But big speakers are there, then it shows that vibration. Okay, collecting sunlight on a paper with the help of convex lens burns the paper. Have you seen this? Have you done this experiment or not?
Yes.
So what happened there? It can burn that paper. What's the reason behind it? Now, generally, there are so many papers, pieces of the papers are there present on the land, on the ground, then also it not burn. But when you take your convex lens, and that time it will be burn. What's the reason behind it? Anybody?
Because
yeah.
of the light
energy
present in sun rays.
Yeah, yeah. Already now also, sir, light is present, sun energy is there present. But when there are only convex lens we are keeping on it, that time only it will be one. Otherwise, it will not burn. There are so many papers are now there. Everywhere it's fallen.
Sir, can I tell?
Yeah, you can tell.
Sir, what happened when sunlight falls on that lens? The sun rays power is little, but when it's passed through the lens, that small point is on the paper, it's throw double power.
Yeah, very good, right, by Aditya. So very simple thing, what happened, now sunlight is, suppose it's scattered everywhere. But when we are using this convex lens, that time, whatever sunlight would be fall on this lens, it will be concentrated at one point, and due to that reason, it can burn, remember. Okay, understood? When our energies also like this is distributed everywhere, so due to that reason we are unable to do our whatever things required. So if we concentrate our energy at one particular point, one focus, then only we can achieve it, otherwise it's not possible. So from this we understood the capacity of body to perform the work, the capacity of body to perform the work is called the energy. It's called the energy. See definition, the capacity of body to perform work is called its energy. Okay, so unit of work and energy is the same, remember, unit of work and energy is the same, that is a joule in the SI system and arc in the CJ system. Understood everyone? Yes or no, what is meant by energy?
Yes sir.
Yes or no? Anybody is having doubt? Very simple there, the capacity to do work. Suppose you didn't eat anything and I told you, you have to go in farm and you have to do their whole day work. Can you do it?
No.
It's not possible because you are hungry, you don't have the energy in your body, then it's not possible. Without breakfast, without tea, your parents will tell you, today you have to do this lot of household work. It's possible? Not possible. Because without energy, we can't do the work. So capacity of body to work, to perform work is called the energy. Now, there are so many forms of the energy that are present. That is the mechanical energy, heat energy, light energy, sound energy, chemical energy, nuclear and solar energy. We know these names. Now, beyond that, we have to study its types of energy. That is the mechanical energy. About it, potential energy and kinetic energy. Now, potential energy and kinetic energy. What is the potential? Will tell me about the potential energy.
Stored energy.
Yeah, it's the stored form of the energy. So when now we are producing electricity from that dam water, it's stored at one high place and then afterwards we are using for producing the electricity. So whatever is the energy is stored at one place, at one condition, that is stationary condition, or their uniform motion. So this energy is called the potential energy and kinetic energy. What is the kinetic energy? Kinetic means your motion, the moving. Yes, Parth?
So that kinetic energy definition.
Kinetic energy, which is there.
Sir, you yes. told that now. Please, you asked me what is kinetic energy. That definition, can I tell?
Yeah. You can tell, no problem.
The energy which an object has because of its motion is called its kinetic energy.
Yeah, it's mentioned in our textbook, correct? No. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Well, now we are riding on a bike or bicycle. That time we are present in the form of kinetic energy. Okay, our bike or bicycle is working on the kinetic energy. Now, so kinetic energy means when any energy which is present because of its motion of object, that is called the kinetic energy. Okay, so this is your definition you have to remember. Kinetic energy means what? The energy which an object has because of its motion is called its kinetic energy. Now here, when their kinetic energy is, there means some force will be there because its motion and some displacement will be there. So when we are going to speak about the kinetic energy, we will get the formula. Kinetic energy is equal to work done on the object is equal to K dot E, means kinetic energy is equal to F into S. Understood everyone? Any problem here?
No, sir.
Now, how do we get this expression for kinetic energy? So, just we have seen kinetic energy is equal to, means there F into S. So, W for the work, F for the force, and S for the... But, learn in first lesson, F is equal to F. Harshavardhan Bakre. Okay, so it's like this. Suppose W is equal to F into S. So like the same we have seen there, F is equal to, means force is equal to M into A. M for the mass, A for the acceleration. So here we learn that second law of equation, that is S is equal to ut plus half at square. Okay, then u is the initial velocity, 0, half into at square as it is, then S is equal to, means we will get a displacement is equal to half into at square, and force we have got here ma. Understood? Yes or no? F is equal to ma and S is equal to 1 half at square. So same thing, a for acceleration here, remember. Then we can put the W is equal to ma into half at square. Why we have taken this? Because here instead of force we have written ma and instead of S we have written half at square. Understood? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Understood, everyone? Now, what is here? MA into half into 80 square. So, what will get? Half as it is, will keep. But A is double there. So, we can write A in bracket T square. Understood? Yes or no? Because A and T both have their square, so we have written W is equal to half M. At square. So using Newton's first law of equation, what is the first law of equation? That V is equal to U plus At. V is equal to U plus At. So just we got the W. So V is equal to U plus At means initial velocity 0, then At as it is. So V is equal to, we'll get the At. And then we know that V square is equal to At square. What is the reason behind it? Who tell me? V square is equal to At square. What's the reason behind it?
Sir, because upside it is At square.
Yeah, once more.
Upside, according to second law of motion, it is At square.
Yeah, correct. Using the equation third and fourth, this is equal to W is equal to half M A At bracket square. And now we have got V square is equal to At square. Instead of At square, we have to put the value of V. Means instead of At square, we can put the value V square. And then we will get the formula half into M V square. Understood everyone? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Any difficulty here?
No, sir.
Okay, so we have got the kinetic energy formula, that is the kinetic energy equal to work done and it's equal to half mv square. Now, one example is given on it, that is a stone having a mass of 250 gram is falling from a height. How much kinetic energy does it have at the moment when its velocity is 2 meter per second? What is given there? Mass 250. Velocity means v is given there. 2 meter per second square, but this mass is given in the form of gram. We have to write in the form of kg. We will get there 0.25 kg. So now 250 or 225 kg we can write. Then V is equal to, put the values in the formula, K is equal to 1 half mu square. So what is there? 0.25 multiplied by 2 square. So 0.25 as it is, 2 square we know the 4, and 4 multiply by 0.25, then divide by 2. This 2 is here. 2 ones are 2, 2 to the 4, and 2 multiply by this, then we'll get answer 0.50. Understood, everyone?
Yes.
Any question?
No, sir.
Other students, are you getting it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If you having any doubt, you can ask. Sakhi, any doubt is there? Shreya Kale, speak fast.
No, sir.
Pratnya Gegadmal.
No, sir.
Chaitali.
No, sir.
Patel Darshita, Aniket Chavan.
No, sir.
Purnima Adav is present here.
Yes, sir.
Have you, having you any doubt, any question?
No, sir.
Apeksha. Sartha Kulle.
Yes, sir.
Any doubt?
No, sir.
Utkarsha, any doubt? Patel Darshita. Priya Satpute, Neha Katani. Gaurav,
no, sir.
Tanu Sriladi.
No doubt.
Sriladi.
Yes, sir.
Amruta Gonkar, any doubt?
No, sir, no doubt.
Okay. So now we'll see the next thing, that it is the potential energy. Already we discussed about it, the energy which is present due to the state of that object. Due to the condition of that object, it's called the potential energy. Okay. So here, an arrow is released from a stretched bow. Water kept at a height flows through a pipe into the tap below. A compressed spring is released. So when this compressed string is there, it's there. We have compressed like this, and when we release, what will happen? It can you tell me? Compressed string is there, like this. Compressed, we have compressed one ring, and suddenly we will remove force on it. Then what will happen about this ring? Spring is there, compressed spring. Are you getting it, what I am speaking about it?
Yes, sir, it will jump.
It will be jump. It will be jump. We have compressed by some applied force on it. But when we release the force, it will be immediately, it will be jump. It will not stable. So why this happens? Because some energy is stored in it due to the condition of compressed. Okay, so from this we can understand. So the energy stored in an object because of its specific state or position is called the its potential energy. Understood? Now there are 2-3 examples are there. Now hold a chalk at a height of 5 cm from the floor and release it. Now stand up straight and then release the chalk. Is there a difference in the results of the two activities? If so, and why? Suppose you have taken one chalk and from 5 cm distance now we are sitting in this position, we leave. And then afterwards we have to stand up and same thing, we have to leave the chalk. What will happen there? Release means leave from it.
Sir, if we will throw it from 5 cm, then it will not have any reaction. And if we stand up and release it, it will break into pieces because the distance between the ground and the height is increased.
Yeah, there is a more potential energy will be there, and below where the potential energy is there little less due to the height is there less. And one more thing, what happened, there is a less gravitational force will be there, and when it will be fallen from when we are standing that time, it should take the, it require more gravitational force will be act, and it will be suddenly fallen down and it will be break. Okay, so when any object is above from the surface, that time it's there a height is there, its height. Okay. Then mass of the body is there, m, and g is for the gravitational force. The amount of work done we calculated with the formula of force into displacement. Now we are speaking about the potential energy, not the about kinetic energy. Okay, when we are speaking about the potential energy, that time we have to take the force consideration, means force formula we know that m into a. So here instead of a we have to write g, because this object is the at rest or at particular condition is there, specific condition. So due to reason m into g means m into g is there and height here displacement is there h. So we'll get the formula W is equal to mg h. So what is the potential energy formula is there?
W is equal to mg into h.
Yeah, potential energy in the form of work we can say that is the mgh, and directly potential energy also is equal to mgh. Now one example is there. After this example we will stop here. So see this example. 500 kg water is stored in the overhead tank of a 10 meter high building. Calculate the amount of potential energy stored in the water. Now you can see here, whatever our tanks are there at home, we are keeping at the height. Yeah. And then due to reason, without any applying the force or without any electricity, we'll get that water in our household was here through the taps, correct? There, if you observe that, that water which is coming through the tap, there is having the pressure. Have you observed it or not?
Yes.
Why this pressure is there? Because this water is stored and potential energy in it, and when it will release it, immediately it will be converted into the kinetic energy. Understood? And now about this problem, height is given to 10 meter, mass is 500 gram and g is 9.8. Now here we have to take g 9.8 because it will be going to come down. Calculate the amount of potential energy stored in the water. So it's just stationary, it's not like this, okay, falling, or it's not going up. Now so h is equal to 10 meter, mass is there 500 kg and g is 9.8. directly put the values in formula mgh. 10 into 9.8 into 500, multiply this. So you will get here 10 into 9.8. if you multiply you will get 98, and then 98 multiplied by 500 you will get it 49,000 joule. Understood or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Any
yes,
doubt?
Sir.
Yes, sir. If there is any doubt, you can ask me.
Sir, no doubt.
No doubt. Okay.